Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Food Factory for Us International Student Competition Game. This is the third edition, and it's on fighting losses in food, water, and energy. I'd like to introduce to you the organizer of the Food Factory for Us competitions, and that is Professor Paola Pipia, and she is online with me, and you will be able to hear her and also watch her slides. I just want to make sure that you can see my screen. Paola, can you see my screen?
Yes.
Okay, so then we are good. Okay, so now I hand the microphone over to Paola. Thanks.
Good morning, good afternoon to everyone. It's a great pleasure for me to start this webinar with all the representatives of the teams that registered to the third edition of the Food Factory for Us. And Catherine, next slide.
Sorry. I can't seem to control it. Should be better than
that. Okay. So sorry for this short delay that was not planned, but we have some technical problems that actually and that the control of the presentation actually is given to Catherine this morning. So actually, we after a brief introduction of how GoToMeeting is also working for you. We will then move to a presentation I prepared just to focus on the main aims and objectives of the competition, how it is planned to work, and your responsibilities, your duties, but also some tools for you to help you also to get more trained during this student competition. So, Catherine, if you would like to give some words about GoToMeeting, please, the word is yours.
Okay, I'm not sure if any of you have experience with the GoToMeeting tool. So I will let you know briefly that you can participate in this meeting by using the control panel. You will all see a GoToMeeting control panel on your screen. And if you look on the gray bars, you see one that says questions. And there you can write a question and I will see your question. And then I will tell Paola that there is a question and I will read it to her. You cannot talk, your microphone is muted. So at any time, you can go and write a question and I will see it immediately. If you find that your panel is taking up too much of your screen, there is an arrow in the top and you can minimize the panel so that you can better see the slides. If there are any questions about using the GoToWebinar, that's fine also. You can write that in the question box and I will answer your question privately if it doesn't relate to the webinar, only to your use of the control panel. Okay, so with that, I give it back to Paola.
Okay, let's start with the next slide. I would like, first of all, to thank our sponsors and endorsers. This edition is sponsored by the Ezechi Food Association that is also in charge, that, I mean, will be also award, give the award to the winning teams. There is also the endorsement from two other institutions. Actually, one is a project, which is a post-harvest project, an Erasmus Plus one that is dealing also on the valorization of waste, post-processing waste, and Elsevier, which is a good endorser partner also in many Iseki Food Association activities. Next, please. The main objectives of the Food Factory for us, that now is at the third edition, actually is are the improvement of practical knowledge and abilities in solving real processing or food industry-oriented problems that actually are absolutely important. Catherine is gone. The presentation is gone.
Oops, sorry, I don't know what happened. Let me go see. Okay, did it come back?
Yeah.
Sorry about that.
Oh, don't worry. And actually is a way to start working also on innovative ways to learn and to be trained by using also virtual tools like the ones you are using currently. In each edition since the start, we planned to have a specific topic on which we were asking the teams of the students to work on. Because every time, every year, we can have different problems to be solved. And this time, after a very good discussion, we found, Catherine, go back, please. Sorry, to focus the attention on fighting food, energy, and water losses, as this topic is actually of main concern for all over the world, and food industries are working a lot in trying to find the solutions in order to enhance and to have a more sustainable food production in all the steps from the production of the raw materials up to the distribution and the service steps. Next, please. The Food Factory for Us International Student Competition has a scientific and organizing team support, which is chaired by myself. But then we have colleagues from AgroParisTech, Florence Dubois-Brissonnet, Cristina Silva from the Cattolica University of Portugal, Gerhard Schleining from the Boku University in Austria, Christophe Cotillon, which is from France, from Food Industry Federation in France, and then Catherine Fling, which is representing here the Iseki Food Association. Next, please. Activities. What was it expected to do in this competition? Actually, we asked all the interested students to develop, to create, to set a team of students, three up to five, maximum one PhD student, and present actually a topic or that can be, which is related to the main topic of the edition. In this project is important that you develop the idea and the action or the applications that are supporting your main objectives and aims of the project in order to try to find the desired solution. Do this work imply also practical work? Actually, is not required that you carry out also laboratory or a practical work in a company to actually find if your solution is working, because obviously it depends on your abilities, your availability of working in the lab and so on. But what is more important is that the solution you are providing is fully supported by your premises or also by objective data or scientific evidences. The next step, the next slide, sorry. Timing and steps of the competition. After the registration, you get the acceptance. Actually, during March and April, there will be virtual meetings and training carried out always in on by distance. 14th of May is planned to receive from you your report and PowerPoint presentations. Then there will be the step of the evaluation, and then on 14th of June we have planned, but maybe if there are issues we will move this date, but for now it's fixed the 14th of June. We will have the virtual workshop, which will be delivered as in this case as a webinar. And in that session, we will have also, after the final evaluation, the winner announcement. Next, please. The reporting, what we expect from you. Actually, there is a project report. Next slide will be focused on that. And the PowerPoint presentation, where you will also present your project, maximum 20 slides. And this can be also used for the final virtual workshop. Next. In the report, there is a fixed scheme we have implemented also in the previous editions, which is working rather well. The report includes an abstract, some keywords, which means which are the main running words of your project, the main objectives, 200 words, so they must be very clear and synthetic, and then the strategy of the project and the development of the project. In this case, we fixed also the length of each session in order to force you also to write and prepare the reports. The report is also included a final session. Subsession, which is called innovation, potential applicability, and benefits in respect to the state of the art. And this is a rather important session, sorry. All the intellectual property aspects, issues for the teams that have been indicated them in the registration will be properly taken into account. Next step, next slide, sorry. Evaluation. This is rather important, so please read this slide very well, then you will have also this presentation available in the website of the project. Actually, the evaluation team will evaluate the project in terms of originality, and this is rather important. The team of the evaluators could have also the opportunity to evaluate if there are already existing examples in the literature, so your project must be really, really original. The second step of the evaluation will be the written report, so also in this case, the clarity and the overall quality of the manuscript, and then the presentation. In this case, you have two steps. One is which is related to the PowerPoint that you will deliver, and then also the clarity of your presentation, and then during the virtual workshop, also how you will answer to the questions of the people attending and the evaluation board that will be attending the final virtual workshop. Next. What you will get at the end of this students' competition, actually, first of all, certificates. If you reach the end of the competition and you will also participate to the virtual workshop, you will get a certificate. Each team member will receive a certificate of participation, and obviously the winning teams will also get the certificate in this case as winners. The Ezeki Food Association has decided to give awards to three, in this case, teams, and the first will receive 250 euros, the second 150 euros, and the third 100 euros. Next. Training. No, go back. Okay. Training. What we are planning to do for you by distance, obviously. For sure, we will have, and we are just defining now the dates. We have already planned two webinars, which are dealing with the main topics of this Food Factory for Us edition. One is on a project management that will be given by Rainer Schwachinka from SUMO. Is an organization. An organization which is dealing with the project development and the projecting is making consultancy on project management, and he will be very pleased to give you some tools and some additional know how to deal also with your project. The second one is more scientific based, and actually is related to the use of computer vision, which is a very innovative tool to optimize the drying process. Others are actually under definition. But all the information will be both reported in the website, and all the teams will be informed by email on time. As soon as we will have the dates and the title, we will announce them. We will send specific alert emails to you. Next, please. In addition, AgroParisTech is supporting this competition, and they give us the availability for you to participate to a training by distance on food waste. Will be delivered by a teacher of the AgroParisTech. It will start the beginning of April, last for 5 weeks with some videos that will be also supported in the explanations and in the presentation by this professor. And you are kindly asked to register at the link that is reported in this web page, but soon we will send you another email about this possibility for you. It is all these training are for free, so it's a very good opportunity for you to have additional training for your professional knowledge and career. Next. A list of the teams now. Actually, we have 15 teams registered. Here are just the names. Maybe there are some mistakes. So please, I would like to ask you all to write either in the chat or by email if you find errors or mistakes. I have to apologize that maybe some emails, if I didn't reply to you. Maybe it could be that also in this last week your email went to spam. I started to read all the emails because I was away now, but actually it takes some time. So actually I just replied this morning to one email from a team that I just replied. So here are some of the teams. Next slide. These are the other list of the teams. Next. So overall we have 15 teams registered, some from Europe, but we are very proud of having let's say a good number of teams from India this year and from different universities. So this means that somehow also our competition born or create developed in Europe is getting more and more visibility also in other continents. Next, please. So now I just we can scroll one by one the slides I receive from the different teams. This is the slide of the food savers team that will work on a project on utilization of sesame hull as a waste of food factories for the production of a functional ice cream. Next, please. FIPA from this is a mix team project spent grain fiber recovery. Next, please. Food artisans from India, the University, the Sam Higginbotham University of Agriculture. The title of the project is The Use and Convert Cereals and Vegetable Waste into Dry Matter for Producing Sustainable Energy. Next, please. Team Vision, retrieval of food packaging waste by means of reverse logistics, India as well. Next, please. Food Monks with the project to make a high nutrition energy bar using fruit and vegetable waste to fight food, energy, and water wastage and world hunger from India as well. Next, please. Food Inners, incorporation of a byproduct of a wine industry to develop a meat analog. In this case, is a mix team, Quiliven, University of Portugal, Catholic University of Portugal, and the University Anhalt, I think it's German, if I'm not wrong. Next, please. Revivers from Egypt, a longer title, reducing food losses of highly perishable foods, making new products. Actually, this is not a title of a project, but it's the description. So I would suggest the teams to find actually a very concise, more brief title for their projects. Next, please. Vinhotech, winemaking process optimization and waste conversion from Quiliven in Belgium. Next, please. Food Resolver from India. The title of the project is Food Waste Control and Management. The title does not include all the presentation of the topic that obviously we received. Next, please. Lost a title here. This is the food tech. I don't remember exactly the name. The topic is eco-innovative novel technology for the development of a sustainable system in food, energy and water from India. Next. Oh, he's arriving now. Techno-foodies professional. Next, please. Then the Food Warriors, that is a mixed team also in this case. The project title is the valorization of a side stream from vegetable and brewery industries to develop healthy and tasteful vegetable muffin. Next, please. And this is the Vision. With the title Recovery and Utilization of a Waste Product Generated from Unregistered Butcher Shop of Region by Making Them, and so on. Too long a topic, project title again. So, my suggestion is obviously to make more short titles, especially for the presentation. Next. Again, NIFTEM. Enhancement of quality and shelf life of watermelon by using watermelon peel based coating treatment from India. Next, I think is the last that I found actually in my spam folder. Drop it. The name of the team is Cyclos. Drop it. Actually, is they changed recently the topic and actually. They were looking at their project and found that the initial idea was already developed. So thank you, Irenaeus, and all the team for having done this double check. So now maybe your project will be really innovative. Next, please. I think that is all for now. Maybe I may have lost one or two team slides, so please send me again. I will try to check if they went on the spam folder. Now is the time for you to make questions if you need any clarification or any additional information for you to work. I don't know, Catherine, if any of the participants has written in the chat box questions or clarifications.
We had one question asking okay. If it's will be available.
Sorry, if
the PowerPoint slides will be available.
And yes.
Yes, there will be a link on the competition website.
Yes, what I would like to suggest you is to have always a look to the website to see if there is new material available for you, new information available for you, because obviously you will also receive emails from us, but then you can obviously find all the training material that we will make available for you available in the website, in the web pages dedicated. Last but not least, I would like also to suggest you to have a look to at least one webinar if you are interested that was delivered last year. So all of these webinars are make available for you. They are free. So you can have a look, for instance, to the webinar that has been delivered by Professor Luciano Piergiovanni last year on bioplastics for food packaging that was actually focusing on also the reduction of food waste and the food packaging materials for fighting waste in the food production. And this is obviously something that you can have a look whenever you like. They are free for you.
I don't see any other questions being written. I will also say to the attendees that you can raise your hand. You see in your control panel a way to raise your hand. And if you raise your hand, I will give you the microphone and then you can say your question if you prefer that to writing it. So either one, I can see if you raise your hand or if you write a question.
I would like to say also some in this case is a question I would like to pose to you all. If you like to have specific trainings on specific topics. So now is the time that we can adjust our training program for you according also sp to specific needs. So if you would like to have needs in time, sorry, training webinars dedicated to, I don't know, any topic, we will try to see if we can find speakers, experts that can support you in this topic. So this is something that you can either write on the chat now, but maybe you can also send us an email. Just for optimizing the communication among us, when you write an email in the object, please indicate Food Factory for us. This is what we see. You all can also see in this slide. Food Factory for us 2019, and then the question for which you are sending the email either to me or to Catherine or both.
We have a question from
Okay.
Gemma Leon. Just to confirm, there is no communication with one specific mentor. We just work on the projects and submit to each deadline.
Yes, actually, it's not expected that this time because we had some problems in the past. It's not expected that you have a mentor. At least officially, you don't have a mentor in your team. So you should and you have to try to work by yourself because this is a student's competition. And we don't want to make any difference among the teams that have a tutor and the teams that do not have a tutor. Catherine?
That was clear for Gemma. She responds, thank you. And the question box is still open, or the hand raising for any other questions from the students.
If not, we can move to the next slide, the final one, actually, just to not waste so much time. Actually, also waste the time waste is a precious thing that we should take into account. We are planning to have another virtual intermediate virtual meeting like this one. In that case, we will better focus and we will ask you to send us some comments or advancement if there is any issue also in to be discussed. And this is planned beginning mid of April. Now we have to check our agendas, our diaries, and if there are no other questions from your side, I would like to wish you a good work, good development of your project, and for sure see you soon. Catherine?
Yeah, no more questions. So I also say goodbye, good luck, and we look forward to seeing your projects.
Okay, thank you. Thank you very much. See you soon.